You know, I don't know. It's hard to say, you know, I'm looking back on this. There's so much going on. You know, we're the very first sled off the hill. You know, we were number one. So basically they said, you know, we didn't know how fast we were going to go, if we had a time to beat. We had to set that time. Actually, you don't really hear the crowd. You do it first because, like, sometimes what's unfortunate about bobsledding is the crowd is awesome because they're so loud, they're so excited, and they're so amped up for you about to compete. But you can't, like, we have a cadence that we have to in order to make sure we push at the exact same time we have a cadence, like, oh, that's, you know, kind of a countdown. And it's very hard to hear it if people are screaming. One key here is the 475. That was the start record at the time. That was actually a very pretty solid push. My team is extremely efficient and fast at getting into the sled. I think that's one reason why we were so good. Actually, as I'm watching this, pretty good run. I'm surprised. The mistakes, I don't really see a whole lot of major mistakes in this first one, but it was also when we set the track record. So typically are able to, on the first run, put down a good run, and just for some reason that just seems to be our team thing. If we can go out first, we'll be dangerous. On the fourth run, we were the last sled to go down the hill. We were winning, so of course they reversed the order, so we were last. And you know, what happens is, like, every team starts going down, and by the end of it, you're the only team left up there. So it's just like first, second, third place are just the only people left up there, and you're all fighting for these medals. And you know, they said the third place goes out and goes down, and second place, and then it's just you. Going into this run, I remember thinking, you know, I was thinking more of, like, don't be the guy that blows a 4/10 lead. Don't be that guy, you know. I was more worried about making a mistake than I was about getting the gold medal. Like, it was, which is the worst thing you could think of. You know, you need to be more of, like, confident. And I was like, I just don't choke, be that guy. Goes down in history for blowing the biggest lead in bobsled history. It was a little slower than our other pushes. I think enough that we wanted to make sure, like, just we got 4/10. Let's do this. And then right out the first curve, I made a huge mistake, which I hadn't made all week. And, like, in that moment, I was like, okay, there's no more mistakes. And it was kind of from there on out, just make sure that I hit all the points that I wanted. You can't see that you won until you get up to the top. So you're coming up this hill, and you can see everybody looking out, trying to see our time. And then you came across, and everybody was doing that. And it's... I remember this so vivid. I couldn't get my helmet off. I was stuck. Everybody's taking their helmet off, and I'm just standing there, like, I can't get it off. I don't know. It was just kind of surreal. You know, I think it's what we planned, set out to do. But when all of a sudden it happens, you're like, oh my, like, we just did it. Like this is happening. And I think you can kind of see, I remember the little, like, watching my face a little bit. Like, it's hard to believe. It's one of those moments where, you know, we did a lot of mental training going up to it, that we were so prepared that when we did win, we were kind of like, yeah, we won. You know, you're still kind of like, we kind of expected to win, because that was the mindset going in. Like, you have to be ready to win. I mean, it really is overwhelming. These guys that, you know, we set out on this quest, you know, a few years before, and just been through, you know, ups and downs and highs and lows, and just, you know, to be up there finally and have reached that goal and been through so much together, it was just kind of, it was overwhelming. That's cool.